If you've been using Adobe Premiere Rush for a good while, guess what? There's a huge, huge update Adobe just released this past week, and it is speed ramping, speed adjusting. I'll show you how to do that coming right up. What's going on, everybody? Claudio here, and welcome to a new video. If this is your first time checking out this channel, first of all, thank you for stopping by. If you like what you see, want to learn more about what you're about to watch and other stuff like photography, video, graphic design, consider subscribing to this channel by clicking on that subscribe button on the lower left, somewhere over here. As I mentioned at the beginning, Adobe recently updated Premiere Rush to include speed adjustments, which is super awesome. If you haven't used Adobe Rush, you might want to check out this video here to give you a little more walkthrough of it. It's available on your iPhone, on your iPad, Android, as well as your computer, PC, and Mac. So let me stop talking about it and show you. I'm going to jump onto my iPad to show you how to slow down footage. So here we go. So here you're looking at my iPad. I'm going to choose to add media. I shot some soccer footage my daughter was playing in the backyard, so let me call this soccer slow-mo. And as I mentioned earlier, this is shot at 120 frames per second. So whenever you want to slow down, I highly recommend shooting at a higher frame rate. 60 to 120 is perfect. When you slow it down, it looks a lot smoother. So here I'm going to take this right here and slow down when she's doing some kicks here. So several things here. Let me click on the speed icon over here on the right. Is you have the option to maintain audio pitch. So if you are slowing or speeding up footage, you can actually maintain the pitch of audio instead of sounding like squirrels or like kind of like a slow motion person talking. You can kind of tap that on and off. It doesn't always work great. It just depends on what the audio is. In this case, what I'm going to do is actually mute the audio because I don't want to hear any audio. I might put like a soundtrack behind it. So let's go back to the speed icon and let me zoom in here. So here she is getting ready to kick. So I'm kind of scrubbing through and right about there, I'm going to trim that, throw that away. And as you can see, this got the speedometer at the beginning and at the end. What I'm going to do is drag that right about there, and then at the end I want it to go back into regular speed after she kicks through. So she kicks and right there it goes, put it a little further. So as you can see, it says 100%, so it's still regular speed. So right below where it says range, in between those two speedometer icons, I'm going to tap and hold range speed and bring it down to about 33%. So now when I scrub through here, right now it's going slow because I'm scrubbing, but check this out. Once I hit play, and there it goes, slow motion. Let me slow it down a little more. Bring it down to 20%. Now because I shot at 120, I could actually still go down to about 25 and still be close to like at 24 frames per second, if my math is correct. And now she's back. So what I want to do about right there is that's where I want it to go back to regular speed. Hit play and boom, and now she's back to regular speed. Really cool feature. Look at that. Easy to do on a tablet, phone, on the computer as well. Now this next option, you have ramp. What ramp is, basically think of it as you're going on a highway or off a highway. You speed up or slow down as you're going to kind of merge with fast traffic. So let's kind of think of it the same way here. You're basically smoothing that transition from regular speed to slow. So let's see how it looks now. It's a nice transition and it's not very choppy. So again, I'm going to turn it off and play it again. Here we go. And then it cuts through, but if I ramp it, it's really neat. Very smooth. Nice. I like that. So if I wanted to speed up that clip, I basically would just go the opposite direction. speed it up. So regular speed is at 100. So let's go to 200. So let's see what happens. So there we go. Fairly fast there. And for this clip, I wouldn't want to do that speed, but just to show you, boom. Basically, you can't even see her kick the ball. It goes fairly quick. So let's bring it back down to 20 there. Hit play again. Nice. And that's how easy it is to slow down footage in Premiere Rush. This is so awesome. I've been waiting for this feature to be on this application. The great thing about it is it's on here. So I can edit on the go. If I go on vacation, sit on the flight, I can edit all my footage and be done with it by the time I get home. Super awesome. So if you haven't updated your Adobe Premiere Rush software, I highly recommend do that now. If you enjoyed this video or learned something new or have a question, please let me know by adding it in the comment section below and hit that like button. If you're looking for more videos like this, consider subscribing to the channel by clicking on that icon and turning on your notifications. And as always, thanks for stopping by to check out this video. Be good to one another. Peace. I'm out of here.